Good evening all. Bit of strength training tonight. Slow it all down a little bit from all the high intensity charging around stuff. Good evening Sue. How you doing? Michelle, how are you? So we need some weights. You do need a chair, not just to rest on. You do need a chair. You don't need any shoes on, you'll be fine. Shoes and socks, not needed. How you doing, Michelle? Sorry, there's no Boris Becker or Stefan Edberg outfit tonight. Hi, Nikki. I have to work on that one. I definitely have to work on the hair for it. Need to get Sue to gather up some of the hair that she's cutting off and make me a Boris Becker wig. From 1983 or whatever it was. What's going on here? You and Chris here, all good, excellent. Hello Hannah, how are you? Ooh, chair, yes, you need a chair. You do need an instrument of torture, definitely. Pat Cash, he was my favourite, right. That's a mullet, isn't it? Pat Cash had a mullet going on, didn't he? That's Sue, I'm leaving that one with you. You need a Pat Cash mullet, alright? Next outfit, Pat Cash tennis gear and a mullet. I'm sure you can handle it. I can't think who Pat Cash was sponsored by, but there'll be a headband involved somewhere. Probably a bandana. Pat Cash was probably bandana man, wasn't he? I would think. Strikes me as a bandana sort of guy. Right, so yeah, you do need weights. Heavier the better. You do need a chair. Hopefully something solid. Not convinced mine is, but anyway. Something solid. And water, towel, all that sort of usual stuff. Other than that, a little bit of energy, and we'll see what we can do. It's all about the legs this week. It's all about the legs. So let's move the chair out of the way for a moment. Let's get rid of that. And we'll just get ourselves limbered up a little bit. So just flick those heels up to the bottom. Nothing too drastic to start with. Just see how we go. And then we'll get those knees lifting a little bit. We don't need to be charging around on anything tonight. But we will still get a good old sweat on. Because although it's fairly miserable out there, it's still quite warm. Right, now what I want you to do, just get over as far as you can to one side, squat down and then just wobble your way across as far as you can and then back again. Activate those glutes, wobble your way back. Those glutes warmed up. See what we can do with these legs. Anyway, Sue, how are your legs? Have you been with all this standing up you're having to do all day long? Are you finding that they're fatiguing through not actually moving? There's one thing doing a class, rest it there, but it's another thing just moving around a chair. I guess the other thing is, how's your Fitbit faring up? Is it counting those little steps around the chair? Or do you find that they don't count? I often find when I'm training people, I just do little movements and don't get registered at all. Get those knees up. Not that I'm too worried about that, but get those knees up. Limber everything up. Right, from here, do a wide squat. Back to the centre. Wide squat the other way. Nearly there. Nearly time to pick up a weight. There we go. Don't worry, there's not too much moving side to side stuff when it comes to the exercises. But there is some painful stuff going on. One more time each side. Excellent. And just a little shake out, just gonna have a little sip of water. Pop that down. Okay, grab whatever dumbbells you want. This is just part of the warm-up still. we're going to do 20 alternate lunges, okay? So just grab the weights of your choice, okay? And we'll just do alternate lunges. Stride it out. Keep the torso up nice and high. Keep the shoulders vertically aligned with the hips. Don't let them fall over the front knee. And get that back knee down nice and low. I think that's halfway. Team. 15, 16, 17, 18, and one more. Very good. Right, we'll pop those ones down. So, we're going into goblet squats and wide squats. Okay, so the goblets, feet are narrow. Okay, so we start with the feet hip width apart. That is not hip width. Hip width apart, okay? And you're pushing the weight back through the heels. You're gonna hold your weight up here. I'm gonna be using a kettlebell, but if you're holding a weight such as this, goblet, so we're in this position, so it looks about the size of a glass that many of you may fill up to, you know, put your Prosecco or your gin in. All right, so nice big goblet. So just from here, don't worry, we haven't started yet. From here, the elbows, just as a target, are heading towards your knees, driving straight back up again. Try and keep your back as flat as possible, okay? That's the plan. So 15 of these. Stupidly, I thought I could go with something slightly heavier. All right, so feet hip width apart, and now big deep breaths in, inhale down, elbows to the kneecaps, exhale up, squeeze at the top, inhale, exhale, two, nice and steady, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Getting down towards the kneecaps means that you go down nice and low all the time. Working on that range of movement. Five more. Four, nice and smooth. Three. Two. And the last one. Oh, very good. Pop that one down. Oh, it's got a bit of a sweat on already. Don't worry, we'll be coming back to that. Wide squats. We're not going to use any weight. Okay, so wide squat position, you know, slightly, I'll go around this way. So 10, all the way down, all the way up, okay? So one, same thing, get those elbows heading towards the kneecaps. Three, weight back through those heels, keep the back flat. Four, five, six, seven. When we've done the 10, we'll do all the way down and halfway back up again for 10. So that is 10, all the way down, halfway up, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. When we've done these, we're just going to stay at the bottom for a count of 10. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 10 full ones, all the way up, all the way down. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep that back flat, keep those abs in nice and tight. On. Exhale as you drive up. Good. 2 more. 1 more. Brilliant. Oh, shake those legs out. Yes, warming up a little bit. Good news. We're going to do that all over again now. Okay, there is no rush to any of these. Just about getting the quality and getting the burn going on in those legs. So grab your heavy weights again. Why did I pick this? Narrow squats. Elbows to the kneecaps. Down we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. 5, 6, 7. Drive up. 8, 9, 10. 11. Ooh, you're up nicely. 12. Keep that back flat. 13. Keep that core locked on. 14. Wow. 15. You can go down there. Oh, was that easy a second time around? Just warmed up a little bit. Come on, tell yourself it was. Back to those wide squats. Give yourself another 10 seconds. Calm it all down a little bit. Same sequence. 10 full, 10 halves, 10 holds, 10 full. Okay, simple as that. Boring those toes out a little bit. 3, 2, 1. Down we go. Elbows to the kneecaps. 1, 2, 3. Nice and low. Keep that back flat. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, all the way down, halfway up, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, stay strong. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, up. Woo! And down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, stay strong, 9, and 10, wow, shake the leg out, or 2, dripping on that one, absolutely dripping. Okay, it's still hot when you start training inside. Oh, right. For this pairing, we are doing it 3 times. So we've got 1 more time. The next ones, we only do them twice. Okay? Got to give you something to hang around for. There'll be some good news going on. Right. I'm going to take those off. Just dripping into them. Put those on in a minute. Back to those narrow goblet squats, okay? Grab that weight. get yourself ready. Underneath the chin, feet hip width apart, pushing the weight back through those heels. Inhale down, exhale up, two. There we go. Number five, and number six, seven, nice and smooth, nice and low, eight, concentrate on the quality. Today is not about speed. I think that's 10, quality, range of movement, four more, four, three, two, one. Woo! I'm gonna pop that one down. Yes. Another body workout, that thing. Right. Those wide squats. Give yourself another 20 or 30 seconds before we go into those wides. And then the fun begins. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Not that this isn't fun, but that's what we have in store. You get a chance to sit down. Feet nice and wide. Wide squats, 10, all the way down, all the way up. Good, one, good, two. Weight back through the heels again, three, four. Keep the weight back, keep those abs pulled in nice and tight. Good. Nice and deep. Two more. Good. Nice little warm up this one. Now we're going all the way down to halfway up. Good. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, keep smiling, 1, and hold, 10, 9, 8, 7, don't cheat, 6, 5, get your bottom down, 4, 3, 2, 1, all the way up for 10, 9, 8, keep going low, 7, 6, you'll get much stronger, much quicker by giving yourself the range of movement. Work those muscles through a longer range. You'll get them stronger and longer. Last one. Fab. Woo. Shake those legs out. Brilliant. Have a little mop down. Brilliant. And now, little drink. And I do need to grab my glasses because I need to just reconfirm exactly what I've written down. Okay. So this is where the chair comes in. So, split squats. I'm going to stick it over here. Stick it around that way. Can you see that? If I have the graphics in a way, but hopefully you can see that. So we're going to put one foot on the top of the chair, hop forward to then load it down and down, okay? So that's the plan, all right? If you want to hold weights, fab, absolutely go for it, okay? But you don't have to. You're putting a lot of weight onto that front leg in the first place, okay? So if you don't want to put any extra weight through it, that's absolutely fine. But if you want to give it a challenge and go for it, then feel free. I'm actually gonna turn my chair around. I'm gonna grab some weights, but just slightly lighter than the super heavy ones. So you've got a 15 to do on each side. I'm going left leg forward, right leg back, okay? And then, obviously you don't need to concentrate on me, so you're going down and up, down and up, three, Stabilize. It's getting wobbly. 13. 14. And 15. Oh, that's not cheeky at all, is it? Wowzers. Right. Yep. Other leg. Take that left leg back. Right leg forward. And then down we go. One. Two. As low as you can go. Three. Make sure that knee doesn't travel too far forwards over that front foot though. Six. Seven. Eight. Four, nine. And gripping. 10. Number 11. 12. 13. 14. And a very drippy 15. Very good. So I deliberately did my weaker leg first to get it out of the way. Now I'm going to finish on that slightly more comfortable one. It's all relative. Still pretty uncomfortable, but felt slightly more comfortable. It's amazing the heavy weights. They do get a bit of a sweat on. Right, just confirming again, deadlift, yes. So I'm going heavy, straight leg, deadlift, okay? I'll do it this way around. So, from here, soft knees. We're gonna pick some dumbbells up in a second. The back stays straight, okay? We're talking hip hinge. So from here, hinge forward, go down as low as you can. That's as far as I'm gonna go. I've got a stretch through here. I've got a stretch through here, okay? So as far as I'm going, I'm having a soft knee, okay? Because for me, this will compromise my lower back. If I go with a straight leg, I'll actually only get to about here and something will kink, and I'm not happy with that. So I'm softening the knees, not bending, but just softening, and then hip hinging. What you don't want to find is that when you get as far as you can this way, you then do this. That is not a deadlift. You've then broken the core. You've stopped engaging around the middle, all right? It's all about this and the hamstrings. Your booty and your hands. It's all we're interested in. We're not interested in working the lower back on this one. We want the legs and the bum. So grab those weights, okay? From here, nice and steady, nice and smooth. Down you go, as low as you can. Feel that stretch in the back of the legs and slowly pulling back up again. Down we go. It's all about the control. The amount of the time that you've got these weights in transit, you're putting everything under load. Keep that back flat. Three. Getting a nice stretch through those hamstrings. Four. All the way back up at the top. But you don't need to get to the top and then do that. Don't want to do that. Just get back to neutral. Stand up. Tall. Six. Seven. Quite a nice little stretch out after the other one. Eight. Nine. And 10. Five more. Just for reference, again, this is me and my back. I will never do these ones fast. It will compromise my back and I will go and hurt something. So I will always do these ones slower. That's made me lose count, so I'm going to do two more. One more. But again, it's about the range of movement and the control you can put over it. No point blasting away and bouncing through the exercise. You've just cheated your way and said you can do the weight, and actually you can't, because you haven't done it as well as you could. All right, so it's all about quality, range of movement, not speed. I'm afraid we're going back to our chair. Okay, again, I'm going left leg forward, right leg on the back, like that. There we go. Nice, some stability, easier said than done. Down we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Warming up. 8. Whew. 9. 10. 5 more. 5 more lovely ones. 4, 3, 2, and cheeky or what? Ouch. There you go. Now the right leg forwards. Left leg back. There we go. 15 on this side. 1, so much stronger. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, wow, 15. Oh, yes, indeed. I'll get rid of those two as well. Have a little towel down. I think I might have lost weight in lockdown training. Yeah, hope not. Right, back to those deadlifts. Whichever dumbbells you choose, back to them. Okay, this way around this time. There we go, 15. Stretch through the back of the legs, all the way back up again. So, keep it controlled. 2, 3, 4. Don't worry, we haven't finished with the chair. 5. We've got more to come with the chair. 6. Different exercise, not the same one. Keep that back flat. 7. Keep those abs locked on. Stretch the back of those legs out. 8. 9. 10. Good. Keep everything strong with these last 4. Pull those abs in tight. Good. Don't lose it now. There you go. Should we go one more? Brilliant. Oh, very good. Right, yeah, pop those ones down and out of the way. And once again, where's that towel? So yeah, we are bringing the chair back into the party. You're gonna like this one. Not. So, we're going to do single leg chair squats. All right. Sounds great, doesn't it? Single leg chair squat. So, got just a kitchen chair, dining room chair, whatever you might have available. I'll do it side on, then I'll do it front on. We're going to alternate the legs, okay? So you go down on one, come back up again. Go down on the other leg, come back up again. So, make sure that you're fairly close. If you start here and think you're gonna sit down on one leg, all you'll do is end up bashing your back on there and sit on the floor. So, start off fairly close. And if needs be, you can actually start off on the chair, but you'll see what I'm talking about. So it's not easy. For me, it's not easy. Might be easy for you. Take the left leg off the ground, and then you squat down, stand up. Left foot down, right leg up, squat down, stand up. Okay, so that's what we're talking about. I'll do it front on as well now. But you can possibly see that if you start too far away from the chair, you'll miss it. Okay, so start reasonably close because the knee will travel forwards. So you don't need weights for this one. All right, we'll give those a miss. So we just do 10 for this first set. All right, so there's only 5 on each leg, but you'll get the message that this is quite tough. If it's too low, if the chair is too low for you, put a cushion on it. All right, just pad it out a little bit and just lift it up 2 or 3 inches, okay? Because, you know, yours may be lower than mine, you might think, actually, I can't get back up again. Equally, the chair might be too high. It might only have little legs. Anyway, we won't go there on that one. Right, let's go for it. Lifting, I'm going left leg first, doesn't matter. One leg up, squat down, and stand. Pop that leg down, squat down. 2, 3, control. 4, 5, nothing else to help you here. 6, and we all have different skills and strengths in different areas. And so, some of you might think, do you know what? I can do this all day long. Fantastic. That's what we like. Okay, we'll just do one more. Excellent. And shake those legs out. So not too bad. We'll increase that on the next round. We're going to lie ourselves down now and do shoulder bridge. We're going to grab a reasonably heavy weight and put it over one hip to do shoulder bridge. Okay? So, just lying ourselves down on our back. I've got the long weight. I'm taking my left leg straight up in the air and then lift up through the right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 15 of them, 9, 10, 11, high as you can, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Very good. Just give that a little shake out, and then we'll take the right leg, or the other leg, up in the air, and then 15 on that leg, up and down, up and down. That's it. Squeeze the glutes. 4. Watch out for cramp in the hamstrings. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5, 4. Warm up a little bit, isn't it? 3, 2, and 1. Very good. Yeah. Rest that one out of the way. Beautiful. Right. We're going to go back to our chair squats. Single leg chair squats. Now that I've made the floor nice and sweaty there, and nice and slippy, that's a good idea. So, this time, we'll up the ante a little bit, challenge you a little bit more. So, we're going to do 16, okay? You can either do alternates, or I'm going to try 8 on the one leg and an 8 on the other leg. Okay, so it's entirely up to you how you do it. Will you just keep chopping and changing, or do sets of 4, sets of 4? It's entirely up to you, but just challenge yourself. Off we go. 8 on each side there, whichever you're doing. There we go. And up. Going to tap the ground in between time, that's fine. Good. 2, 3, 4. Now it's warming up a little bit. 5. Ooh, a wobble on that one. 6. Could call it a cheat, but actually I just fell. One more. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Probably could have got 2 or 3 more out, but I wouldn't have wanted to do many more. Other side for me. There we go. Ooh, not finding my balance there. 1. Good. Control. Good. Sometimes I'm finding myself, I'm sort of falling into it. So to get the control, engage and control it down. Drive up. That drive up is, focusing those quads. 7. And 8. Fab. Whew. Yeah, that's warming the legs up a little bit. I'll give you a moment to finish off if you're not quite there. Equally, give you a moment just to shake those legs out before we get to the floor and do those shoulder bridges once more. Okay, time to lie down, get that little weight on a hip, and then lift the other leg up in the air, and then bridge up and down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, give it as hard as you can, 8, squeeze the glutes, 9, 10, it's getting warm now. 12. But we want a bit of heat in there. 13. 14. And a glowing 15. Slide the weight across the other side a little bit. Just give that other leg a little bit of shake out before you extend it up in the air. Off we go. 1. Feels easy for the first few, doesn't it? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 10, 5 to go, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, brilliant, again just slide that weight to one side, brilliant, okay. You've got 2 more exercises to do once, okay, to finish these little legs off. Just one more set. Let's have a quick drink, quick towel down. I'll just run outside for a shower tonight. So all we're doing, we are going back to the first pair of exercises, okay? So narrow goblet squats and then wide squats, okay? That's all we're doing. I'm choosing to go a little bit lighter on my narrow goblets. So feet hip width apart, pull those abs in nice and tight, keep the back flat, down we go. Good. One, elbows to the kneecaps. Good. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. Nine. Five more. Four, three, and two, and one. Very good. Just going to get rid of that little weight. Good. And now, those wide squats. Those wide squats going 10 full to begin with on the dry patch. Put a cycle around here, all the way down, elbows down, one. And be honest with the elbows, the hands are down here, it's not working. Three, good. Four, back flat still. Five, if you can't get to the elbows, get the elbows to the knees. When you're bending your back, don't bend your back. Just stay that little bit higher, but do try and get your bottom as low as you can. This is all about bending the knees. It's not about bending the back. It's not a back exercise. One more. Good. Now all the way down, halfway up. Good. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, ooh, 3, 2, 10 holds, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 10 full, 1, oh, 2, almost takes your breath away, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, nearly there, 8, 9, and brilliant. Shake a leg out or two, have a little towel off and a little drink, and then we'll have a good old stretch those legs. Oh, there you are, you're back. Okay, let's take one leg back, push that heel down, push those hips forward, stretch through the calf. To begin with, oh, we can forget the upper body tonight, we don't need to worry about that. But we certainly burnt a few calories, one way or the other. Mild tension in the back of that calf. And now just bring that foot forward a little bit and then drop that knee towards the floor a little bit to stretch lower down in the calf into the soleus. Good. And then we'll rest that one there, swap the legs over, take the other one back. Push the hips forward, lean into it a little bit more, get that stretch through that calf. We work these legs well, so hopefully they'll be really appreciating a little bit of a stretch out. And now bring that foot forward a little bit more. And then just drop, just squat down. Keep that back heel on the ground. Drop the knee towards the floor to stretch that lower calf out a little. And relax that one there. And then good chance to use some tools. Grab the chair if you need to. I'm just going to grab the foot. Stretch those quads out. Yeah. Sometimes you just want to get a good stretch. So don't worry about the balance, actually worry about the stretch. So really pull that foot up, push these hips forward a little bit, just get a nice stretch down the front of that thigh. Stretch it all out. And then the other side. Knees together, standing tall. But I hope it's been beneficial, that you've enjoyed it. Got a good burn out of it into those legs. Relax that one there. We'll, I'm going to turn the chair around to do the hamstrings. I'm just going to stick one leg on top. Slightly deeper stretch into those hands there. Just enjoy that stretch there. So we'll be back again next Thursday for some more weights. Slightly different again. I think we'll be going back to more upper body, but we'll keep it varied. Upper body and core stability, I think, is on the agenda next week. Relax out there. There's a bit of a, I do plan this, do think about this. Yeah. We're just thrown together, God forbid. Very good. Relax that one there. Superb, guys. Well done. Hope you've enjoyed it. Hope you got something out of it. Hopefully it's not just sore legs, but a little bit of that. And we'll catch up with you again soon. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Possibly get out for a walk. It's not too drizzly now, but we shall see you all again soon. All right. Take care, guys. See you soon. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay positive. Bye.